Hi guys, Oming Tawid here from smartpinayinvestor.com, and in this video I'll be sharing the very basics of building your wealth with the stock market. So in this video I'm gonna share with you the key ideas on the overview of Philippine stock market, how it works and how you can start, and some basic strategies that you can start on. So this is a good video if zero knowledge ka pa rin about stock market and you want to learn how it can benefit you and how to actually begin. And if wala ka pa namang account, you can watch our previous video, how to start and open a trading account. So this is actually the first step if you want to invest, as you will learn later on. And once you have your trading account, you can follow yung ating next video to have a basic understanding of how online investing in stock market works. And for other lessons for newbies, you can download your free ebook for beginners. Punta lang kayo sa website na ito. And for more practical videos, you can subscribe to our channel. So make sure to click the notification bell para aware ka for every practical video lesson that I'll share with you guys. So with that said, let's go back to our lesson, building your wealth with stocks. So first, just a quick rundown on the basic concepts. So let's go to our stock market overview. So yung first question that we ask is obviously, what are stocks? So by book definition, stocks are shares of ownership in a corporation. So familiar kayo dito sa mga biggest corporations we have in the Philippines. And these shares or stocks are traded or exchanged in a place called stock market. And locally, we have one stock market in the Philippines, which is Philippine Stock Exchange or PSE. Technically, when you own a stock, you are therefore a part owner of the company. Though practically and in reality, wala actualing bearing iyon dahil hindi ka naman majority shareholder. So you really don't have any control how the company will operate. Always remember that your primary reason why you are in the stock market is to make money through proper investing or active trading. And hopefully this video will help you do that. Now that we cover what stocks is, second question is why invest? So the big reason really is that you want to invest because you want to make your money work for you. So all your life, you have devoted majority of your time earning for money, diba? So you have spent many years of your life working in a job to earn your salary, your paycheck, or to maintain a business to generate profits. At first, you are in a life stage called man at work. Then later on, once kumita ka na and you have some savings, you can start making your money work for you through investments. So pwede itong sa stocks, sa business, sa real estate, or any other kind of investment. Now, you wanna come to a point na when you retire, you will no longer need to be working for money, but it's your money now working for you. So kahit natutulog ka, kahit wala kang ginagawa, you can still make money with your investments. And yung common benchmark natin in terms of assessing the performance of any paper investment is the inflation rate. So one goal that you will also want to have when you invest is to at least beat the inflation rate. And as you know, inflation is the rate of change or increase in the general or average price of goods and services typically purchased by consumers over a period of time. And as a result, because of inflation, bumababa yung purchasing power of your money. So that means your 10,000 pesos now won't have the same value next year, 5 years, or 10 years from now. So it's the principle we call the time value of money. If we look at this picture, so yung year 1 niya, say ito yung ating previous year, yung price ng basket with all its contents, let's say it's 100 pesos. But after a year, you will now need 102 pesos to buy exactly the same basket. So in that case, there is a 2% inflation. If we look back at our experience, so dati yung 1,000 pesos mo can fill a pushcart na sa grocery. Ngayon, the same 1,000 pesos din na makakapuno ng small basket. So toiletries na lang pwedeng kulangin pa. So yun yung reason why we want to invest in different investments. So with that reason why we should invest, yung next question ngayon for us is how do we earn exactly in investing in stock market? So there are two ways how you can earn in stock market. First is yung tinatawag nating capital appreciation, and second is by receiving dividends. Capital appreciation essentially is an increase in the price or value of assets. So yung ginamit kong term dito is assets, which means yung capital appreciation applies not only to stocks but on any other kind of asset like land or real estate. And this capital appreciation is also called capital gain. So yung difference ng iyong sale price as compared to your purchase price is your capital appreciation or capital gain. And because of that, so pwede rin magkaroon ng possibility of having capital loss in case mas mababa yung iyong sale price compared to your purchase price. As an example, let's take a look at Jollibee. So ito yung price chart ni Jollibee from June 2013 up to May 2020. And we can see na umakyat yung price ni Jollibee ng 142% from 2013 up to early 2018. So yung price ni Jollibee noong June 2013 is around 135 pesos. And then early 2018, umakyat yung price ni Jollibee ng 300 pesos plus, which means more than double actually yung nangyari sa yung investment kung nag-invest ka kay Jollibee in more than 5 years time. However, after that, nag-crash naman siya from the peak ng 53.9% in roughly more than 1 year. So if nag-invest ka from 2013 tapos hindi ka nakapagbenta noong 2018 and 2019, come 2020, parang walang nangyari sa investment mo. So parang break even ka lang except doon sa dividends na na-receive mo during that time. So yung gain mo, yung pera mo, na sana ay kinita mo ay naging bato pa. Ang masama pa is paano pag nakabili ka sa tuktok. So malaki na kaagad yung lugi mo by this time. And take note that this is Jollibee. So this is a huge company na part ng sinasabi nating blue chips. So here we can see that even though we're handling stocks na tinatawag nating blue chip, there's no guarantee na magiging profitable na agad yung investment mo. And there's a proper way of doing it. And just to show you the bigger picture, so ito yung price chart ni Jollibee in the past 20 years. Diba? So here we can see yung power of capital appreciation. From 2000, ang price niya lang is around 20 pesos. And then through the years, unti-unti siyang umaakyat. So even though may mga fluctuation siya na up and down in every single trading day, if ang long-term trend niya naman ng stock is uptrend, then walang magiging problema if you are doing it for the long term. And then one good thing about stock market is you can see the performance of your investment in a very transparent way. So here is a sample portfolio na pwede mong makita sa iyong trading account. So you can see in clear terms in your trading account how much you are earning or also losing in every stock that you have in your portfolio. So here we have Cebu Air, yung ating operator ng Cebu Pacific. We have First Gen. Ito ngayon yung Retail Pure Gold. And ito naman yung SM Prime Holdings na nag-ooperate ng mga SM Malls. Again, with online trading, you can monitor the performance of your investment anytime, anywhere because all you need to do is a device and to be connected sa internet. And as mentioned, there's also a possibility of capital loss. So in this case, mayroong negative returns for the stock EEI and for TEL, which is PLDT. So yung mga active traders, whether day traders or swing traders na tinatawag, they have strict cut loss level they follow to actually avoid huge losses. But for long-term investors, they don't really mind yung mga temporary fluctuations like this as long as the company they are investing in is doing well in the long run. So meaning yung earnings growth ng company remains intact. And the way they manage risk is more on doing diversification. So bibili ka ngayon ng more than one stock under different industries. And mas malaki yung pwede nilang ma-afford na cut loss level as compared to active traders. Alright, so that's so much with capital appreciation. Now we go to the second way of earning in stock market, which is called dividends. So dividends is the distribution of a portion of company's earnings to a class of its shareholders. And yung type of dividends na pwedeng mabigay ng company sa kanilang mga shareholders can be cash, dividend, shares dividend, or what we also call property dividends. So you can imagine yung dividends as the salary you receive from the company by being its stockholder. And normally, these dividends are given annually or semi-annually. So here's a sample cash dividend I received from Globe. So as you can see here, ang stock code ng Globe is GLO and yung cash dividend na dineclare ng company is 22 pesos per share. And during that time, I have 75 shares of Globe. So all I need to do is to multiply it and I will get the gross amount of my dividends, which is 1,650 pesos. But since mayroong 10% na withholding tax in all cash dividends, I receive a net amount of 1,485 pesos. So pwedeng ganyan kalaki yung dividend na marireceive mo. But here's another example na mas maliit coming from Jollibee naman. So this was more recent. So ang kanyang payment date is May 2020. At ang dineclare niyang dividend is 0.62 pesos per share. And during that time, I had 320 shares of Jollibee. So if we multiply the two figures, we get the gross amount, which is 198 pesos and 40 cents. And then ibabawas pa rin yung 10% withholding tax for cash dividends. And therefore, I receive 178 pesos and 56 cents cash dividends. So if mapapansin nyo, yung dividend income that you receive will depend doon sa dividend payout per share and doon sa number of shares that you have in your portfolio. So let's look at another example. So ito namang PLDT na mas malaki naman yung binibigay niya. So ang cash dividend niya is 39 pesos per share and during that time I have 315 shares of PLDT. So ang net amount ko, if you do the same calculation, is 11,056 pesos and 50 cents cash dividend. So pwedeng ganun kalaki or pwedeng ganun kaliit. Yun yung kagandahan sa dividends, whether you are a big shareholder or a small shareholder, retail investor like us, parehas lang din yung dividend rate na marireceive natin and depende doon sa number of shares that we have, yung marireceive nating actual dividends. And one thing to note no is that not all companies pay out dividends. So it's the company's board of directors that will decide whether or not to pay out a dividend in any given period of time or year. And we can simply check yung announcements of dividends sa PSE website or sa broker account mo. So you can check our previous webinar on how to be entitled to a dividend if you want to learn more details on earning through dividends. So now that we are aware how investing in stock market can be beneficial to us, yung next question now is, how do we actually start investing? And there are only three things na kailangan mo so you can start investing. First is, of course, yung capital. Obviously, this is your buying power. Since you are buying a share or stock, we need cash or we need the capital to do that. Fortunately, with as low as 1,000 pesos, you can start building your wealth. So ito yung minimum opening capital para makapag-open ka ng trading account. And that's actually yung second thing na kailangan mo, no? So you need to open a trading account under a broker. And ang kagandahan din dito is we now have what we call online brokers. So you can check our previous tutorial on how to open a trading account online. And lastly, you will need to have the time to do the buy and sell orders and the skills in actually choosing stocks. Dahil sa Philippine Stock Exchange, we have more than 250 plus stocks. So it's a big challenge for the investor. Paano ba pipiliin yung stocks na bibili nila and kung kailan sila bibili and kailan sila magbebenta. So again, this is actually the biggest challenge that you will need to do as a direct investor. Madali lang kasi yung magkaroon ng capital and mag-open ng trading account. Ang question is, can you make your capital grow? Again, pwede kang tumubo, pwede kang kumita, depende sa skills mo. And in terms of brokers, we have here the most common online brokers we have in the Philippines. So ito yung First Metrosec under Metrobank Group. This is bpitrade.com under BPI. We have Call Financial, also called Call or COL. We have BDO Nomura na affiliated with BDO. We have PhilStocks. We have Maybank, ATR Kimeng, MakeTrade, and we have 2Trade Asia. So there are several other online brokers we have in the country, pero ito yung mga pinaka-popular. And to open an account with them, so just check their website for the complete steps. So pwede nyong i-google yun, yung kanilang website. And yung process naman no, is similar to opening a bank account. So kailangan mo lang mag-submit ng application forms and a copy of your government-issued ID. And like before, na kailangan mong pumunta sa mga offices ng mga brokers, now pwede ka na rin mag-open ng iyong trading account online. In fact, you can do it using your mobile phone. So ganun lang kadali mag-open ng trading account. And again, this is just a one-time application process. And pag nakapag-open ka naman ng account, then all your transactions like funding and buying and selling stocks can be done all online. So that's it with the brokers. Now we go dun sa third requirement, which is yung time. Gaano ba karami and kadalas ka kailangan mag-monitor sa stock market? And for us to answer it, so bibigyan ko muna kayo ng background about what we call the trading hours ng ating Philippine Stock Exchange. So in the Philippines, every trading day, which means Monday to Friday except banking holidays, our market is open from 9:30 a.m. up to 3:30 p.m. And meron lang yung market recess sa tanghali from 12 noon to 1:30 p.m. At 1:30 p.m., so magre-resume yung trading. And during this market open, or what we call trading hour, so constantly nagfa-fluctuate yung price of every stock we have in our stock market. So at 9:30 a.m., meron siyang tinatawag na opening price. And then pagsara ng market ng 3:30 p.m., every stock will have its own closing price. So sa mga TV news and market updates and market coverages na makita mo, when you hear the word that the market o yung isang stock close at this level, then it means yun yung price ng market or ng stock when the market close at 3:30 p.m. The next trading day, kinabukasan, pwede mag-open yung stock at an opening price different from the previous closing price. So, depende na yun sa new prevailing demand and supply. So, paano kung empleyado ka and you have your working time at 8 a.m. to 5 p.m., so medyo mahirapan kang makapag-monitor and makapag-place ng buy and sell orders during the time when the market is open. Well, pwede ka pa rin namang mag-invest and mag-place ng buy and sell by using what we call yung off-hours facility ng broker mo. So with the off-hours order facility ng yung broker, you can enter orders after market closing in preparation for the next trading day. And ito yung sample screen kapag mag-place ka ng off-hours order. So ilalagay mo lang kung ano yung transaction mo, whether buy or sell. And then yung term, which is ATO or ATC. So ATO means at the opening and yung ATC is at the close. Tapos ilalagay mo rin yung iyong stock code and kung ilan yung shares na bibilin mo or ibebenta mo. Kung mapapansin nyo, wala kang nilalagay na price dyan because yung price na gagamitin ng order mo will actually depend doon sa opening price if you choose ATO or doon sa closing price if you choose ATC. So, pwede nyo munang skip to kung medyo naguguluhan pa kayo. But ang point lang nito is you can place your buy and sell orders even after the market has closed using the off-hours facility ng iyong order. So, hindi mo actually kailangang nakatutok ka sa stock market during the time na nagtatrabaho ka sa iyong business or sa iyong trabaho. So, again, these are the three things na kailangan mo. You need to have capital, you need to open a trading account, and you need to devote at least some time. And you need to have the skills to manage your investment. And now that we have discussed yung capital, online stock brokers, and trading hours, let's now tackle how stock market works. But before we proceed, if you are enjoying this video and want us to make more videos more often, then please hit the thumbs up button to show your support. Make sure to subscribe and click the notification bell to get updates on our future lessons. Also, if you have questions or thoughts while watching this video, then please do share it in the comment section below. So going back to how stock market works, so right now you have extra capital you want to invest in stock market, and then mag-open ka ng trading account sa iyong broker. And once you have your trading account, then that means you can now start buying yung mga stocks ng mga companies na gusto mo. And again, these stocks and shares are traded in our Philippine Stock Exchange. And then once nakita mo nang tumutubo yung investment mo, you can actually sell it anytime. And finally, you now have your money back with some decent profits. So hopefully, meron kang profits. So this is you with your capital. And ito naman yung iyong broker where you do all the buy and sell transactions and where you manage your stock investment. And then ito yung ating Philippine Stock Exchange. And this is the same broker that you use to sell your investment and you get your money back. So those are the three things that you need to have. Your capital, your broker account, and yung time and skills. And if you notice, you yourself have to do the biggest challenge na kailangan gawin ng every investor, which is yung stock screening and to find out when it is actually best to buy and sell stocks. And for newbies, malaking challenge yun, lalo na kung wala ka namang time to monitor the market closely. So if you don't want to do this kind of direct investing sa stock market, you can instead do what I call indirect investing sa stock market using mutual funds. So let me just share yung brief comparison between stock market and mutual funds. Sa stock market kasi, you are called a direct investor because you are self-directed. So mag-isa ka lang. And again, all you have to do is to open an account, but you also need to analyze and screen your stocks. And once na-screen mo na yung kailangang stocks na gusto mong bilhin, then you can now start buying and selling stocks. So that's in the case of direct investing sa stock market. In the case of mutual funds, so ikaw ito, pero hindi ka lang mag-isa. You are called an indirect investor and meron kayong grupo na mga other retail investors and institutional investors and meron kayong inassigned na fund manager. And itong si fund manager will be the one to do the analyzing and screening stocks. Siya rin yung gagawa ng buying and selling stocks. And siya rin yung gagawa ng monitoring and updating yung mga stockholders ng mutual fund. So ito yung picture kanina with direct investing sa stock market. If you want to do indirect investing dahil wala kang time to monitor the market closely, then you can instead invest in mutual funds. So napalitan lang yung Philippine Stock Exchange nitong ating mutual fund. So in this case, ang binibili mo na is a mutual fund and not the specific stocks. And sa likod ng mutual fund, nandoon yung mga stocks na binibili ng mutual fund companies na binibili din nila sa Philippine Stock Exchange. So yun lang yung main difference between stock market and mutual funds. So pwede niyong panoorin yung ating previous video on how to find the best performing mutual funds in the Philippines. Again, when you invest in mutual funds, wala na actually kailangang skills to do the analyzing and screening of stocks kasi you will have the fund manager to do the job for you. All you need to do is to select the mutual funds or yung tinatawag nating mutual fund providers or companies. So that's it with mutual funds and the three things you need to have and you need to do when you want to invest in stock market directly. Again, yung trading account is just a one-time step lang whereas your capital and time that you allot will depend on you and depend on your strategy. And now that we mentioned it, let's now talk about investing strategies. So when it comes to the stock market, you will most likely fall into one of the two main groups of investment styles. Meron tayong tinatawag na passive investing and meron din tayong tinatawag na active trading. And when you are starting, it's a very crucial step na alam mo kung ano bang investing style ang gagawin mo. Why? Because yung mga activities na kailangan mong gawin later on will depend on this investing style. So let's go to our comparison. So when you are doing passive investing, you are called long-term investors. And one example of doing passive investing is when you do a buy and hold strategy. So itong mga buy and hold investors, they buy stocks and hold them for many months and often many years. Another strategy under passive investing is yung tinatawag na cost averaging strategy. And in this strategy, you buy with fixed amount regularly. So let's say 3,000 pesos every month or 5,000 pesos every month. So you invest that regularly whether the stock price is up or down. So in this case, very minimal time lang yung kailangan mo because you don't have to do market timing. Ang kailangan mo lang gawin is bumili ng stock at your schedule. So if you are doing buy and hold, then that means lump sum investing. One time ka lang bibili. While if you are doing cost averaging strategy, then you just have to buy when it is your schedule. So kung monthly yan or quarterly. So again, minimal time lang yung kailangan mo and you don't have to monitor the market every trading day. And in this case, you have a much longer time horizon, pwedeng 12 months or longer. And long-term passive investors rely more on the strength and the quality of the company's business models and on sa financial report and financial health ng company. And yung thesis dyan is that yung long-term growth ng stocks is highly correlated with the company's earnings. So the better the earnings growth over the long term, the more a stock will grow in value. In short, long-term investing relies on what we call fundamental analysis as opposed to traders which do technical analysis. And many long-term investors are less active than traders. Some long-term investors will only buy and sell stocks monthly, quarterly, or yung iba even annually. So that's with passive investing. Now let's do to active trading or ito yung mga tinatawag nating short-term traders. So a trader approaches the stock market from a short-term perspective and therefore has to do what we call market timing. So some traders buy and sell stocks multiple times during a day and they are called day traders. Ito yung mga bumibili ng stock and nagbebenta ng stock on the same day. Other traders, they hold their positions or stocks for weeks or even months and ito yung mga tinatawag nating swing traders. And again, definitely, these active traders will need more time and syempre yung skills in analyzing and in screening yung stocks na bibili nila. Many stock market traders must be active during the trading day, during market open, and they need to keep an eye on their positions to prevent losses as well as to find new opportunities that are available in the market. Again, they have a much shorter time horizon, trading single day, trading few weeks. And finally, yung traders try to earn as much as possible from the price action or dun sa volatility ng stock. Both day traders and swing traders use what we call technical analysis to find stocks to buy and sell. And may mga ginagamit silang indicators like support and resistance, moving averages, and more, which can aid them in their entry and exit signals. And the way a trader attempts to manage their risk is by limiting yung potential loss nila per trade. For example, many traders limit yung total loss of a trade nila sa isang stock to 1% of their total capital. So yun yung tinatawag na value at risk. So we can discuss more about this in our future videos. And the good thing to note here is that these are just general principles when it comes to devising your own strategy. And with this information, you can adjust and create your own strategy depending na doon sa time that you can allot and depending na rin doon sa capital that you have. So if we go back doon sa price chart ni Jollibee, if you do, for example, buy and hold, the most important criterion that you want to have is that yung company will have a long-term uptrend. So bibili ka ng stock ni Jollibee at this point, and what you would want to do is to hold it until masaya ka na sa profits mo. And if you notice, marami yung up and down during the years, and yun actually yung biggest challenge na kailangang harapin ng mga buy and hold investors, because imagine, 50% ng iyong investment magda-down, and then makaka-recover na naman siya, and then magda-down na naman. So imagine yung roller coaster emotions that you would experience when you do buy and hold for the long term. And yung biggest risk na kinakaharap ng mga buy and hold investors is they are also prone to market crashes. So for example, in this case, 2019 up to 2020, so yung price level ni Jollibee, yun lang din yung price level niya nung 2013. So imagine nag-buy and hold ka dito, tapos nag-antay ka, yan, hindi ka nakabenta dito, tapos inabot ka ng market crash. So baliwala lang yung time period na nag-invest ka, except of course dun sa dividends na na-receive mo. But yun actually yung biggest challenge ng buy and hold investors, because if they don't do market timing, they are also prone to market crash. Now, if you do peso cost averaging, ang gagawin mo naman is every month or every quarter, then you will keep on buying stocks. And ang main criteria here is dapat long-term uptrend din yung stocks mo. Kasi kahit nag-average ka, if long-term downtrend naman yan, then malulugi ka pa rin in the long run. So ang gagawin mo dito, for example, bibili ka dito. So regular yan, monthly bibili ka. Even during those times na bumababa yung stock price, let's say temporary lang naman yan and hindi naman nakakabit doon sa business earnings ng company. So if naka-recover yan, then ultimately mag-earn ka pa rin using cost averaging. Finally, in trading, so what you would want to do as active traders is to buy and sell whenever you see an opportunity based dun sa entry and exit signal na meron yung trading system mo. If active trader ka, ang gusto mo is nakabenta ka here, nakabili ka dito, nakabenta ka here, nakabili ka dito. Of course, mas madaling sabihin yon kaysa gawin. Pero yun actually yung ideal na gustong gawin ng mga active traders. So those are the two kinds of strategies na pwede mong gawin when you start investing in stock market. Ang question ngayon now is, what strategy is best for you? The reality is, both trading and long-term investing can help you grow your money. So if you're interested in a more active role, buying and selling stocks during the day or during the week, then active trading will be better suited for you. Yung iba kasi is, they really have the time and they love the thrill of real-time trading, and mas malaki din yung pwede nilang kitain pag na-master nila yung skills. Now, if you're the one naman interested in a bit more of passive investing, then being a long-term investor will better suit you. So you can be a long-term passive investor that buys and sells stocks infrequently if wala ka naman din talagang time mag-monitor ng market. And you can even be a more completely passive investor by investing dun sa pinakita nating mutual funds instead of individual stocks. So if you don't want to do the work to find the stocks to buy, then investing in mutual funds will allow you to hold stock market investments without doing any work. Ang gagawin mo lang is maglalabas ka lang ng capital and you will choose your mutual fund. And si fund manager na ngayon yung gagawa ng lahat sa'yo. But that comes with a fee. And the good thing is, whatever strategy you use, whether passive investors or active traders, yung brokers mo naman will most likely have the resources that you need to help you do the strategy that you want. For example, if you have an account with COL Financial, meron silang report na tinatawag na calling the shots, where they have specific stock picks that they share with its clients. So Calling the Shots is a monthly publication by Call which provides insights on investment opportunities based on global and local developments that could affect the market. So meron silang tinatawag na model portfolio that you can practically copy in case gusto mo silang sundin. Aside from that, they also have the investment guide. So meron silang kinocover na stocks and they have here yung call rating which is whether buy or sell or hold. They have the fair value, they have the buy below price, and then some financial ratios and information about dividend yield. So that's it for passive investors. And for active traders naman, meron din silang technical guide reports. So meron ditong stocks that they cover and meron dito silang technical guide whether it's buy or sell into strength and more. So pwede niyang i-check and kung meron ka namang account kay BDO Nomura, so meron din silang weekly wrap report which is very similar dun sa report ni Call Financial. So they have here target price or yung fair value based on their analysts. And then they have their ratings here and some financial ratios. And if you are into active trading naman using BDO Nomura, meron silang technical reports called Technically Speaking where they have analysis of stocks, where they have charting for the stocks that they cover. And for First MetroSec naman under Metrobank Group, meron din silang stock screen. So in case you want to do value investing, in case you want to have a portfolio that is more focused on dividends, so yun yung tinatawag nilang yield seeker portfolio. And for active traders, meron din silang in-offer na Traders Playbook. For BPI Trade naman, so they have practically the same table, no? Investment guide, the stocks, yung kanilang rating and yung target price or fair value and then some financial ratios. And similarly for active traders, they have this top picks and meron din silang binibigay ng mga technical reports and charting analysis. So in short, any broker will have its own set of resources that they offer to its clients whether you want to do active investing or you want to do passive investing. So yun actually yung strategies na pwedeng yung pagpilian and pwedeng yung pag-aralan. Of course, depende sa circumstances mo. But before we proceed, if you are enjoying this video and want us to make more videos more often, then please hit the thumbs up button to show your support. Make sure to subscribe and click the notification bell to get updates on our future lessons. Also, if you have questions or thoughts while watching this video, then please do share it in the comment section below. And for us to see yung details about dividends of each stock, so we can go here under research, fundamentals, and then we have here investment guide. And here we can see yung table of stocks that is being covered by colfinancial.com. So hindi naman lahat no, na 200 plus stocks under Philippine Stock Exchange yung nandito. So they only cover a few select stocks. And what is nice here is they already have here they have call rating and call fair value. So yung call fair value is essentially yung kanilang target price for every stock that they cover. And then meron silang buy below price. This provides you a guidance on when to actually buy and sell para hindi ka naghahabol ng price or yung tinatawag nating chasing prices. So using this buy below price, so you are protected with a good margin. So kung ang target price mo, for example, kay BPI is 76 pesos, if you will follow this buy below price guide, you will not buy if yung current price ni BPI is higher than 66 pesos. And then you will only buy if yung current price niya is 66 pesos or below. So essentially, ayaw mo kasing habulin yung price ng BPI dahil magiging maliit na lang yung capital appreciation mo and mas malaki yung tendency no, na mag-correct yung stock kapag lumalapit na siya sa kanyang fair value, at least in the long term. And then you have here more columns. So these are just some financial ratios and financial informations relevant for fundamental analysis. So we have EPS or earning per share, EPS growth, PE ratio, and price to book value ratio. And then if you want to learn about the dividends na in-offer ng stock, mayroon sila ditong dividend yield in terms of percentage. So if we go for example kay BPI, so that has a dividend yield of 2.5%. So definitely mas malaki siya sa savings account interest rate. So if we go naman dun sa quotes ni BPI, so we can click on the BPI code. Ayan. So in the quotation, we can see practically all the information specific to this stock. Ito yung kanyang current price. This is last 70 pesos and 55 cents. Ang previous price niya or yung price niya in the previous trading day, which was yesterday, is 72 pesos. So therefore, bumaba yung kanyang price ng 1 pesos and 45 cents from the previous price. And expressed as percentage, that is negative 2.01%. So ito yung tinatawag nating capital loss. And again, itong mga short-term fluctuations is very important for active traders, but it's not really so much a big deal for those who are investing for the long term. Ang mahalaga kasi sa long-term investors, again, is yung long-term trend nung stock. And if you want to learn more about dividends, so we can click here, meron ditong dividend section, and we can see yung historical dividend declaration ng BPI. And meron ditong ex-date, record date, and payable date. So again, you can watch yung ating previous video detailing yung importance ng mga dates na naka-attach to every dividend declaration. So it's not automatic that pag bumili ka ng stock na may dividend declaration is magiging eligible ka na. So meron kang kailangang i-observe na dates, and you can learn more about it sa ating video available in our description. So if we go for example naman kay PLDT, ang ticker code ni PLDT is TEL. So click enter, and then go sa dividends. So makita din natin dito yung historical dividend declaration ni PLDT. And yung latest nga, no, year 2020 is 39 pesos per share. So ang payable date niya is April 3, 2020. So tapos na actually ito. And if napansin niyo, ito yung dividend example na pinakita ko kanina, no. So that's 39 pesos per share. So this is a very convenient way, no, of earning sa stock market, because if yung stock mo is consistently nagde-declare, so most likely as long as the company is earning year on year, so meron yang i-declare na dividends, and you can take part sa kanilang earnings by receiving dividends. Okay? So right now, the market now is closed. So we can see here yung kanilang status, and therefore, hindi na tayo pwedeng makapag-open or makapag-place ng order because salado ngayon yung market. Ang pwedeng na natin gawin ngayon is go dito sa off hours order, pero hindi pa rin ito available, no. So I think for Call Financial magiging available ito by 7 p.m. or later. So pwede niyong i-check 'yon. But with this off hours facility, you can place your orders even if the market is closed, and then magiging available or magiging live yung order mo during opening on the next trading day. Okay? And then para naman makita natin yung portfolio, I can go here sa trade, click portfolio. Ayan. So makita natin yung aking stock position. So I only have one stock, that is Metro Retail Stores Group INC. Ang kanyang stock code is MRSGI or Mrs. G, no? And currently I'm at a loss of negative 2.99%. In terms of absolute loss, that is negative 296 pesos. So again, hindi naman laging gain sa stock market. So if you are investing for the long term, hindi mo kailangan tingnan ito every day. And as long as invested ka sa mga magagandang companies which will have a long-term uptrend, you are practically safe. Okay? But if you go to active trading, then mas malaki yung risks. So mas malaki yung kailangang requirements, mas malaki yung monitoring, and kailangan meron ka mga strict rules na sinusundan para maiwasan mo mag-incur, magkaroon ng malaking loss. So yun yung basic information that I can share with you right now when it comes to navigating yung iyong trading account. So yung ibang brokers will have a different display, but practically meron din silang home, and then you can see yung quotes, trade, they also have their own set of researches, and then yung iba may mutual fund din, no? So si COL Financial, mayroon silang tinatawag na call fund source, which enables you to also invest and buy mutual funds. Hindi lang stocks yung pwede mong mabili kay call, but also mutual funds. So mayroon tayong previous video also detailing how to invest in mutual funds. So it's a very similar process to buying and investing in individual stocks. Okay, and then yung pinakita ko kanina na calling the shots or yung kanilang recommended stock pick. So pwede nyo makita yun dito under research. And then calling the shots here, you can see here yung kanilang latest report. Ayan, so ito yung kanilang latest report as of May 29, 2020. And somewhere on this report, sa dulo, makita mo yung kanilang stock picks. Ayan, so currently, they have four, no? P Gold, CNPF, PLDT and FGen. And then again, ito yung kanilang target price. And yung buy below price will help you determine whether it's good to buy this stock based doon sa current price and sa buy below price. In other words, maraming information available yung mga brokers mo, no? So it's not just Call Financial. So other brokers, meron silang specialized researches, meron silang mga technical analysis reports. So huwag kayong masyadong ma-intimidate dito sa inyong trading account, because normally, this is really overwhelming, lalo na sa mga newbies. But later on, as you gain more experience and as you check your portfolio once a week or even every day, you will get acquainted. And again, pwede nyo panoorin yung aking previous video detailing how to navigate and how to maximize yung paggamit nyo ng inyong trading account. Alright? And that actually concludes our lesson for today on building your wealth with stocks. So these are very basic but practical information that will serve as your foundation when you start investing and when you start developing your own investing or trading style. So for our next video, so i-discuss ko naman in more details yung another strategy, which is called index investing. And we will also dig deeper into the buy and hold and peso cost averaging. So itong two techniques kasi will not be profitable all the time. So anong market conditions magiging profitable yung mga strategies? So malalaman natin yon in our future video. But itong index investing, no, so this is one approach that I really recommend to people na sobrang passive investment style ang gusto. As I have shared with you, sa stock market kasi when you do direct investing, so you yourself will have to do everything. From funding, from stock selection, and from buying and selling stocks. But in index investing, so this is a simple strategy where you don't need to do stock selection and you will also not be doing market timing. So this is a good lesson for our next video. And if you like this video and want to learn more, then please leave your thumbs up, like this video, subscribe to this channel, and make sure to click the notification bell so you get updated for every future video lesson that I'm gonna share with you guys. Also, if you have questions or thoughts, or if you have topics you want to be discussed in our next video, then please do share it in the comment section below. So thank you again, guys, for watching this video, and see you in our next lesson. God bless us all. Bye!